Hello everyone, my name is Ritwit and I'm a master's student studying at CI. I'm going to talk about how I made IU my home away from home. So sit back, relax and enjoy the journey. With over a year in the US, I've had tons of fun growing into a better version of myself every time I learn new things. Making new friends, exploring new places, and trying out new things has been a huge confidence boost for me. People from all around the world... Wait. I'm getting ahead of myself. Let's start from the beginning. Before moving to the US, I lived in Mumbai, a beautiful city in India. Living in the city of dreams, we had people from different cultures and dialects. And staying together, we shared all the festivals, danced at different celebrations and carried the same grief. Even though we were divided by religion, we were always united by our love for sports and Bollywood. The day I got my acceptance letter from Indiana University, I was really happy. But I also realized that my entire life was about to change. Living in a new country all by myself is a pretty big task. Flying out of my home country was the most difficult thing I've faced in my life. After I landed in the US, it hit me. I'm 8,000 miles away from home. My HCI cohort has a lot of students from all around the world. We connected with each other instantly, even though we had different experiences in life. We have an Indian community where we celebrate all the festivals, which made me feel really close to my home. I rarely felt homesick. Everyone is so close to each other that I can say what Dom said.
I don't have friends. I got family.
Living here, I've not only improved myself, but I've also tried out things I wanted to do but didn't have time for before. I was a DJ back home but left it due to work back in 2018. When I came to the US, I saw the parties missed one thing, and that's a DJ. So one day, I decided to buy a DJ set to play on various occasions like festivals and birthday parties. This helped me improve my skills, and the crowd loved it. I even got a bartender license from IU when I worked in catering. Looking back to my time in India, I don't feel any difference. Celebrating festivals, enjoying everything with friends, oh, and the love for sports is the same as back home. I love football and support the Hoosiers with all my heart. Oh, wait. A Hoosier? That's right. I'm a Hoosier now. And this is my home.
Dear IU, my name is Anne-Sophie. And this is the story of the little bits and pieces that make me feel at home in Bloomington, away from Rome in Italy, where I grew up. Because I'm a PhD student, I'm doomed to want to organize and make sense of everything that surrounds me. So after hours of brainstorming, I theorized that combining people, places, and practices makes one's home. Let me explain this 3P theory to you. First, people. Feed relationships with people from your old and new homes. For instance, I video call a couple of family members. I pick among sisters, brothers, nieces, parents, aunts, cousins, grandparents, and so on, and one or two friends every week. It's gossip, laughs, cries, whatever is needed. I like sharing a good glass of wine on Zoom to spice up the video calls. In other words, I turn the call into an aperitivo. In addition, good IU friends are a must. Italians are a rare species in Indiana, but I found Laura and Christina more recently. With them, my brain can go off. The rest of my friends come from all over the world, like Mandy, my IU sister in the program. A favorite? Chatting with them outdoors at a bar while sipping a drink. It's that simple. Just like going out in Rome. Second, places. Find homey shelters. There is a sofa in my room. I lay there and listen to Ennio Morricone. Next to it are three photographs of Rome in the 50s. One captures a view of St. Peter's Church from a bridge I crossed thousands of times. There are also two drawings, one from my niece, the absolute love of my life, and one of her I drew. I snuggle here when I need a hug. There is also Little Italy, a tiny supermarket 2 blocks from my apartment. I go there to mind transfer to Rome anytime I feel like it. When I'm there, I drown in Italianhood. in products like biscotti della Mulino Bianco, cookies I grew up with, pasta molisana, prosciutto, taralli, magical crackers, Roman pecorino, and so much more. The feeling is fantastic. Finally, practices. Replicate routines from home. For example, every morning I go to the same coffee shop for a cappuccino. Hearing, "Good morning, Sophie," the usual, literally makes my day. The practice started when I began driving a Vespa to school at 14. One morning my mother said, "Ci vediamo giù." So we met at the cafe in front of home. We had a cappuccino, then she went to work and I went to school. So that's it. The 3P theory works for me. People, places, and practices make IU feel like home. Like any theory, it can be revised, so any feedback is more than welcome. Setting jokes aside, if this video does make it online, I hope it ends up helping other international students. To those students, find your homey people, places, and practices, and you'll be okay.
Dear home, you held me in you for nearly 3 decades. It's in you, 8,700 miles away, 1,800 days back. I had a dream. And so I packed all my life in 3 suitcases to pursue my passion in this land of freedom and dreams. Not gonna lie, moving to the other end of earth was so not easy as I thought. Turbulent, lonely, clueless, messy, real low. And these are just an understatement. If life happened in its own idiosyncratic ways, well, who would have thought that my Indian self would find community and solidarity with a Pakistani Muslim? I was programmed all my life just against this. But this, you know, being able to debate, discuss, and yet sit across the same table and have a cup of coffee or beer, margarita, whatever, that feels home to me. Blending of cultures, camaraderie that extends beyond cultures, mutually adapting rather than completely assimilating, being culturally sensitive and empathetically understanding, finding home in the most unusual corners. IU has given me the experience of a lifetime in just 60 days. I am a Nisa, but in a good way. I'm unlearning and learning. Moments of agitation and pristine clarity have become a coexistence. My ideas are expanding and I'm pushed and driven to give back to my community in my own ways. I'll forever be grateful to my past self for choosing IU. Choosing IU is where my life's plot took a different turn, a whole new chapter of finding belonging within the walls of the School of Public Health, finding ease in outgrowing myself, finding solace in unconventional friendships, finding purpose amidst the turbulence of mind, and finding infinity within my finite life. I've heard of it again and time that home is where comfort is. But finding home outside my comfort zone is so very beautiful and fascinating. IU is my home away from home. IU is my Hogwarts. Right now, I'm walking towards her. I'm walking towards myself. It's getting crimson by the day, inside out. See you soon. Yours with love.